Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Today, and hope you're all doing well. And we're back with some interesting SpaceX updates for you. Beginning with SpaceX's latest Falcon Heavy launch contract, we'll then move on to their Inspiration4 mission to be carried out less than 24 hours from the West Coast Starlink launch. In the end, we'll wrap up with one more Falcon Heavy update. Now, let us start with SpaceX's newly won launch contract for Falcon Heavy. On the 10th of September, Friday, NASA announced that SpaceX had recently got a $152.5 million launch contract of the GOES-U satellite from the agency. According to the contract, the launch will be carried out aboard a Falcon Heavy rocket from the Kennedy Space Center by April of 2024. This NASA contract towards SpaceX has come up after the United Launch Alliance, or ULA, had withdrawn their bid from the launch deal. With this contract, SpaceX got another addition in the launch list of Falcon Heavy. GOES-R, or Geostationary Operational Environmental Satellite R, is a series of geostationary satellites used for weather monitoring. NASA said, "These spacecraft help meteorologists observe and predict local weather events, including thunderstorms, tornadoes, fog, hurricanes, flash floods, and other severe weather. In addition, GOES observations have proven helpful in monitoring dust storms, volcanic eruptions, and forest fires." These satellites were mainly operated by National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, or NOAA, and also by NASA. GOES-R, first in the series, was launched in late 2016, and later it was renamed as GOES-16. GOES-S, or GOES-17, was launched in early 2018. GOES-T is the next one in the series. Its launch is scheduled in 2022. A report says that GOES-T will replace GOES-S. Launch of the first two GOES satellites have been carried out by ULA's Atlas V launch vehicle. GOES-T is also scheduled to be relaunched by Atlas V. GOES-U, whose launch is assigned to SpaceX, is the last satellite in the series. Regarding this satellite, NASA stated, "This satellite will provide advanced imagery and atmospheric measurements of Earth's weather, oceans, and environment, as well as real-time mapping of total lightning activity and improved monitoring of solar activity and space weather." ULA had provided the reason for their withdrawal from the launch bid. Jessica Rye, a representative of ULA, stated that all of the remaining 29 rockets have been sold to customers for future launches, so we had to withdraw our bid for NASA's GOES-U launch service. As ULA is now focusing on their Vulcan Centaur rocket, thus they'd stop building any new Atlas V vehicles. On the 9th of September, Tory Bruno, CEO of ULA, stated, "I've purchased all the RD-180s we require for the Atlas V. There are 29 Atlases left. All of those RD-180s are safely ensconced in a warehouse in Alabama. I believe that it's more than I need to transition smoothly to Vulcan." Bruno also said that there may be no need for purchasing additional RD-180 engines. Report says out of the 29 remaining Atlas V vehicles, 9 have been assigned for launching Amazon's Kuiper broadband satellites. NASA didn't provide any specific reason for picking up SpaceX as their GOES-U launch provider, but according to some reports, it seems that ULA's withdrawal from the launch bid is a good reason for NASA's move. The report also says that NASA's GOES-U contract with SpaceX is a bit cheaper than their GOES-T launch contract with ULA, which was about $165.7 million. After this Falcon Heavy update, we'll look at nearly back-to-back launches planned by SpaceX. 51 upgraded Starlink satellites are successfully launched by SpaceX's Falcon 9. The launch took place from the Vandenberg Space Force Base, VSFB. This was the first mission with the V1.5 satellites having the laser technology. The new technology will allow Starlink to provide better internet to vehicles even at remote locations. This launch was part of Starlink Group 2-1. The success is remarkable. On the 14th of September, Chris Bergen tweeted, "B-1049 becomes the second Falcon 9 to hit the 10 orbital launches milestone, landing on Of Course I Still Love You." really feels routine, but it's still stunning. Apart from its primary purpose, Starlink 2-1 has also helped SpaceX hit another milestone. As Bergen tweeted, Falcon 9 B1049, which made its debut in 2018, successfully completed its 10th launch and landing. Though the launch date was postponed quite a few times due to several circumstances, the launch finally took place. Falcon 9 B1051, on the other hand, debuted in 2019 and by May 2021 became the first booster to the 10 launch record. B1049 took almost 10 more months to achieve that same target. Records also show that Starlink 2-1 is the 24th successful launch of a flight-proven Falcon 9 payload fairing, which reused normal components. The company tried to refocus on reusing fairings that led to gentle landing. Satellites have been designed to tolerate rough and loud environments, allowing things smoothly. SpaceX has launched more than 150 commercial payloads and over 3 launches with flight-proven fairings, indicating a greater demand of the new technology being used. This technology is going to be accepted because of the cost savings it provides. Now, after the first launch being successful, SpaceX might design more laser interlink-based vehicles than the entire world. After placing enough satellites on the orbit, the company can significantly increase Starlink's coverage without even constructing new ground stations. There will be satellites communicating with direct line of sight of a ground station dish. This connects users to the internet. Lasers will further allow a dish's active satellite to pass through the connection to the rest of the satellites. Thus, ground stations can remain away from the users. A well-linked Starlink structure will be better than wired connections by using lasers routing user communications. Just after the launch of its laser satellites, SpaceX is all set to launch its historic all-private Crew Dragon mission less than 48 hours apart. Inspiration4, the world's first crew of all-private astronauts, will be launched into orbit about 8:05 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, Wednesday the 15th. This mission is going to predict a lot about the future of orbital space tourism. As direct tweets from SpaceX on the 13th of September says, "Static fire test of Falcon 9 complete. Targeting Wednesday, September 15 for launch of Dragon's first all-civilian human spaceflight. The 5-hour launch window opens at 8:02 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time." The company is looking forward to this significant launch. We're ending with another Falcon Heavy update to share where SpaceX announced the final dates of its launch. SpaceX has announced the 9th of October 2021 as the final launch date for its next Falcon Heavy mission. Instead of counting weeks and predicting probable dates, SpaceX fans can now put their eyes on a specific day. The date was revealed on the 7th of September in the U.S. Space Systems Command presentation at the 2021 Small Payload Rideshare Symposium. Falcon Heavy is one of the most efficient commercial rockets, other than the Starship, currently. Falcon Heavy Block 5 is an improved version, taking into account all Block 5's reusability and performance betterments. It took SpaceX around 14 months to work and bring into light this new upgraded Falcon Heavy Block 5. After its inaugural launch in April 2019, the company relaunched it for a third time, this time providing the U.S. Air Force with rideshare missions in order to demonstrate the rocket's potentials. However, after that, the rocket hasn't flown yet. Falcon Heavy's fourth launch is supposed to be a U.S. military mission, now known as USSF-44. Due to some unexplained reason, the date of launch is being delayed from 2020 to Q1, Q2, Q3, and finally Q4, which is in October 2021. In late September 2020, SpaceX began qualifying the Falcon Heavy boosters at Texas. However, the work was delayed when the U.S. was undergoing the drastic effect of the COVID-19 pandemic. In May 2021, the U.S. military blamed the USSF-44 delay on payload readiness. Since SpaceX or rocket availability wasn't blamed, it's possible that the satellite manufacturers Grumman, Lockheed Martin, Maxar, or Boeing faced some major technical difficulty. There might also be a case of fault in supply chains due to the pandemic. In between all these events, SpaceX has worked hard on its Falcon Heavy and making it ready for all upcoming launches. Falcon Heavy 4 will supposedly roll to Kennedy Space Center Pad 39A 5 to 6 days prior to its launch date on October 9th for the static fire test and pad shakedown. Following the launch of Inspiration 4, SpaceX will still have 3 weeks to make necessary arrangements and modifications, gather all the stages of the USSF 44 Falcon Heavy, and start assembling the rocket. There's a lot on SpaceX's plate currently, and successfully completing every step as per the schedule is challenging. Regardless of the situation, we can hope to see Falcon Heavy rolling out to the launch pad in less than a month. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.